Hi, I'm Jeff Balti, Director of Cellular Imaging at the Institute for Cell Engineering at Johns Hopkins. My lab specializes in imaging stem cells, and today I'm going to use this toy box to explain what we are doing. Stem cells are the cells in our body that repair tissues, for instance, the heart and the brain. There's something unique about stem cells. If this wiffle ball would be a stem cell, it would make multiple copies of itself that are exactly identical. There are two ways that stem cells can repair our tissue. One is by becoming a different cell type, such as a heart cell or a brain cell. And the other way is that they can excrete exosomes, which are healing substances that look like little bubbles that are secreted by the stem cells and make our own cells feel better so they can repair our tissue. We are starting now to do experimental stem cell therapies. And when doctors inject these cells, they do not know exactly where they go when they are healing the tissue and for how long they survive. Sometimes they even misinject. This is what a standard brain MRI looks like. If this gray wiffle ball would be our injected stem cell, we could not see it in the brain because it has no contrast. Even the best radiologists in the world will not be able to see the gray cells on the brain MRI. I have pioneered ways to make cells visible on MRI by making them magnetic. The way we do that, if this gray wiffle ball again is our stem cell, is we label them with magnetic nanoparticles that go into the cell, and now the cell becomes magnetic. On the MRI, when we inject these cells, because they're magnetic, they will appear black. We can now see them because the magnetic properties of these nanoparticles disturb the magnetic field of the MRI so that there is no signal left. Now that we can see our stem cells on MRI, what can we do with it? One way we can use it for is to follow the stem cells in real time during the injection and see them move. This little car is our stem cell. We can track the stem cells in real time very fast with MRI, and we can see now if there's a traffic jam which may be caused by injecting too many cells or doing the injection too fast, in which case the cells cannot enter the brain. We can change our injection procedure by injecting less cells or by injecting them slower. We can follow them now and we can see where they exactly end up in the brain, where they park nicely and smoothly without any congestion. One final way of imaging our stem cells is to put a reporter gene in them that will give light if we inject certain chemicals. So if this little finger light is our reporter gene, we put it in our cells, the cells will only light up if they are alive, because only then they will make the protein that produces the light. We can even see if the cells divide, because they will make more light. The light will go off when the cells are dying, so we know when they end up working for us and healing the tissue. This can be a day, can be a week, or maybe a month. So we are developing innovative ways of tracking stem cells that will guide a therapy that is based on harnessing the body's own power to heal ourselves.